delighted and honored to be with you on this day when you celebrate coming into a home of your own. What a lovely, lovely place. And what an innovative approach to problem solving. I grew up in a place actually sort of like Hamilton, a very small town in rural Washington State on the eastern side of the mountains in high desert country. A town of about 2,500 people, about 2 hours from the nearest city. So, you know, sort of like this. Beautiful country. It was such a joy to drive through the hills today and come to see you. I bring greetings from Bishop High, who is in Oklahoma today, visiting family on his way home from a meeting of the trustees at Sewanee. I hope that you can hear folks from other parts of the diocese rejoicing with you on this day. I hope that you know what an encouragement your steadfastness and your innovative thinking and your get up and go is to the rest of the diocese. Today is a triple celebration. It's the blessing of your new church building. It's Mother's Day, and it's Mothering Sunday. Have any of you heard of Mothering Sunday? So Mother's Day was not exactly our own unique American idea, you know, when Hallmark cards started having Mother's Day cards about 100 years ago. This idea about celebrating mothers, well, it's a good idea all the time because mothers need to be celebrated, let's face it. But it came from the idea, the British idea, of Mothering Sunday. The tradition of Mothering Sunday dates back to the 1500s in the Church of England, when on Mothering Sunday, in the middle of the season of Easter, everyone took the day to go to their mother church. The church where they were baptized, the church where they were brought into the family of God. Servants were given that day off so they too could travel to their mother church. So I think it's wonderful that on this Mothering Sunday, we are able to come to our mother church. And it's fitting that this would be a day on which St. Mary's starts its new life in this place. It's also interesting to me that the lessons for this day, this fourth Sunday of the season of the resurrection, are lessons about shepherd, right? The shepherd. Jesus, our shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd. In some ways, you might call shepherding the mothering aspect of God. Think of how a shepherd relates to the sheep, providing fierce care and provision and protection. It's a great image of what mothers do: care, provide, protect. It's interesting, as the picture of the shepherd is painted in the lessons that we have for today in Psalm 23, in the gospel lesson, that the gospel lesson we have is not the one that you might expect, the one where Jesus says, "I am the good shepherd." That's not the story that we get in today's gospel lesson. Did you notice that? In today's gospel lesson, we got Jesus saying, "I am the gate." So it makes a lot of sense to me when Jesus compares himself to a person, right? Living, breathing. It's sort of today. So I want to speak to you about how a gate works, the purpose of a gate, and where the gate leads. Jesus is using this image for himself in relationship to his people. I grew up on a farm where we installed our own fences and our own gates. We didn't have sheep, we had cows, you know, cows or sheep, that's usually how ranches and farms go. We had cows. Whether you have cows or whether you have sheep, you have to keep them in, at least during certain seasons of the year. So you need fences and gates. How many of you have ever built a gate? Built a gate? Ha! Okay. Then you know that a very important thing about building a gate is that the gatepost has to be straight and sunk in pretty deep. Because if it's not, what happens? The gate? Everybody's making this motion with their hands. Yeah. If the gatepost isn't straight and strong and sunk in pretty deep, then, you know, it may be that the gate works, you know, initially. But pretty soon the thing's dragging on the ground and leaning all over the place. And, you know, somebody has to, well, this happened to us, actually. You have to drag the gate along. Not very efficient. Not very effective. Not very gate-like for the gate not to open. Jesus is the gate. Access to the good things that God has for us. The gatepost is his cross, sunk in pretty deep, sunk down in the bedrock of God's love for us, and the pivot point for access to new life. That's how this gate that our Lord is works. What is the purpose of a gate? Let people
in and out.
To let things in and out. Let people in and out. Let animals in and out, right? So it can be a barrier for protection. Can offer access. Purpose of a gate is to, at the point of decision, let things in and out. The meaning of a gate, in some way, has to just exactly do with that decision. When you get to a gate, you have to stop for a minute and decide, is this the way we want to go? Is this going to get us to where we need to be? If it is, then you open the gate. If it's not, the gate remains closed and you move on. The purpose of a gate is to provide access and to protect. It is a point of decision. Jesus is the gate. He's the one that meets us at that point of decision. And if we decide to be in relationship with him, he lets us into, well, a whole new world. This gate that Jesus is access to where? Jesus, in giving his life for us, opened for us the way of heaven, which in some ways is the way back to the Garden of Eden. The place that God made for us from the very beginning. This is the idea that God had for us. That he would make a place for us where we would live forever in relationship to him. Then things didn't go very well. We decided not to play by the rules in the place that God stopped having the partnership with God for creativity in the world for which we were created. God created the animals. Adam and Eve gave them names. God set out the rules for Adam and Eve for harmonious living in the garden. Adam and Eve had responsibility to obey them, to follow them, to guide the rest of creation in the way of God. Well, you know, that didn't go very well for them. Doesn't go very well for us on some days either, let's face it. But Jesus is the gate. On the cross, he made for us the way back to the kingdom of heaven and even to the Garden of Eden here on earth, where our responsibility is to be co-creators with our living, loving Lord for the glory of God. So I think it is very fitting that today, on this day, you all come together to start something new. Right here on the main road of town, you provide a gate. I hear there's going to be a new sign. Your old sign's pretty good too. I hear that you're going to have a sign that says, "The Episcopal Church of Hamilton County." That sign will be a gate that says, "We are open, we are here to receive you in the name of the Lord and to show you how you might join us in co-creation with God. New life in our own homes, in our own families, in our communities.